Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This is Pascal Leonard recording for Channel Fireball, and this week I'm going to be playing the deck that my teammate Shaheen Surani played in our middle seat at GP San Antonio. So the GP where I played Crackle Ironworks, Shaheen was playing this deck and Brian was playing Death Shadow. So at first Shaheen obviously wanted to play control deck. It was not forcing us, like, he's not like, hey guys, I'm only gonna play control deck. So he actually tried a lot of other things. You know, he tried like Ad Nauseam, he tried, I think, a burn, he did try Crackle Ironworks for a while when I was on Dredge, and he's very known for playing control decks. And so at some point we were like, we didn't like the Ad Nauseam deck, or we didn't like any of the other options, and we actually thought that blue white control was good, and obviously so did he. And he had a good list that he had been playing and doing well with. So we told him, hey, like, you should probably play this deck, like, you know it well, and like, you have a good list and you have good results with it. And as it turns out, blue white control is actually pretty good in modern right now. I'm gonna make a bold statement saying that modern is at probably its slowest that it's ever been. There are still decks that win on turn 4, but we don't have Infect anymore. Like, the control decks are like, you know, they can't really win before turn 4. It's like Ad Nauseam, Burn. Burn is not really a combo deck, but you get what I mean. Some of these decks, like, Infect, for example, could win on turn 2. It would win on turn 3 pretty often. Like, there's no decks that actually do that right now anymore. Except Kraken Ironworks, which can win on turn 3, but we'll ignore that for a moment because it didn't really exist as we were going into Grand Prix San Antonio. So yeah, we thought, like, blue white control, the problem with it sometimes is that it's a little bit clunky, it's a little bit slow. But since the format is slow now, like, even the Death Shadow list, they can kill pretty quickly, but you're usually more of a grindy deck that kills you. It's like I like to see it as a black green deck, like Jund, that just has a little bit less disruption but kills you a little bit faster. So yeah, blue white control is very well positioned, I think, for that reason. And I like Shaheen's list. I'm playing the exact 75 that he ran at the GP. It's quite similar to Greg Oren's list that won. I think the main difference is that there is no Ancestral Vision in the 75, which I like. I personally really dislike Ancestral Vision. I think it's way too slow for Modern. Even though I just said that Modern is slow, like, it's way too slow. And it's so clunky. I think it's a reasonable sideboard card in general, as a way to beat, like, discards that black decks in general. But I really don't like main deck, and this deck didn't feel like he needed it in the sideboard either, so we just don't have it. So back to the list. Yeah, Shaheen really liked this package of Tectonic Edge and Spreading Seas. So he says that he's winning a ton of game by just locking your opponent out of colored sources. He would Spreading Seas the basics and Tectonic Edge the rest, and that would be enough. And then he would kill with his Cell Shell Colonnade. There's a few weird numbers in the deak, like 1 Mana Leak, 1 Negate, 2 Logic Knots. I'm not going to argue those numbers until I actually play a ton with it. It seemed to be working for him, and I'm going to play with it first to see how it is. There's 1 Detention Sphere. There's 1 Monastery Mentor, which obviously is super weird, but he actually won quite a lot of games with it. Like, his deck doesn't have a creature, so, like, your opponent's probably going to bolt you because he doesn't think you have, like, a creature that he can bolt anyway. And then you just play this, and this kills pretty quickly. Like, with Serum Visions and Path and, like, 1 mana cards like Spell Snare, and you have a ton of cantrips between Spreading Seas and Serum Visions, this actually, like, grows pretty quickly. Grows your big board. And even if your opponent kills it, usually you can play it and actually have tokens out of it the turn you play it. So this is actually interesting. I think it's still pretty random, just have one. But I'm going to try it for sure because it's been impressive when I was looking over at Shaheen's match. The rest of the mana base is fairly stuck. I'm not convinced that Seachrome Coast is better than, like, Glacial Fortress. But that's very possible. Like, with Glacial Fortress and Tectonic Edge and Celestial Conlade, you could have some pretty awkward early games, and I think it's very important to have a good early game with this deck, because once you get to the turn 4, you can at least, like, Supreme Verdict. So, and yeah, Supreme Verdict was a big part of, like, why this deck is good right now. Supreme Verdict is actually pretty good against a lot of decks. Jace is another card that I thought was super weird, but as in, like, it's, I'm like, is this really the best card, advantage card you can play? But the plus one actually does quite a lot, like Lingering Souls and Affinity, just having 1/1s. And obviously, it draws you a ton of card, and it can be a win condition. The deck doesn't have a lot of condition, but you can activate it and, like, steal your one of your opponent's win condition, get your one of Elspeth. Speaking of Elspeth and Gideon, just two planeswalkers that are pretty good against Death Shadow, just black-green decks in general, like Jund, stuff like that. Elspeth is particularly good against Vant Eldrazi, so is Gideon, both killing a Reality Smasher fairly easily. And three Snapcaster Mage, which is an odd number, but the deck doesn't have that many instant sorceries between Spreading Sea and, like, the Planeswalkers and Detention Sphere and 25 lands. So I don't think you want to be flooded with Snapcaster Mages for that reason. This one Condemn and one Blessed Alliance. So this is actually really nice against Death Shadow, because they gain life, right? So you can kill a Death Shadow, and, like, because they gain life, it kills the other Death Shadow, which is pretty sweet. You can do something similar with Blessed Alliance. You can target them so that they gain 4 life. But ultimately, this card is, like, very good against Burn, for example. And it's pretty versatile. It's a nice one with Snapcaster Mage. The sideboard is super stuck. I love it. 3 Rest in Peace. So this is for Death Shadow. This is for Crack Lantern Works, and this is mainly for Dredge as well. Dredge is, like, a really bad matchup for this deck. So we convinced Shaheen to play 3 Rest in Peace because we thought it would be popular, and he did in fact play against Dredge at the GP, and he won the game 2 because of Rest in Peace. Stony Silence is there for Ad Nauseam, Tron, KCI, Affinity. Pretty good right now. I could see having a third, but most of these matchups are actually, like, reasonably good, except Tron. Tron is not good, but Tron is not popular right now. It's mostly Affinity, KCI, and what's the other one I said? Ad Nauseam. Ad Nauseam is not that good of a matchup, but we have Rule of Law there for that matchup. So we ended up with 2 Stone Silence and 2 Rule of Law. Spell Quellers, this is Shane's favorite. He basically boards that in against every matchup. The mentality is that they board at removal, and you just have this that counters everything, and it's a creature, it's a clock, pressures some, like, Lilianas and stuff like that. So Spellcore has been pretty nice, and so I'm going to keep all 4 of them. 2 Core Firecore for Burn, Celestial Purge for Liliana, Death Shadow, reasonably good against Burn as well. And then we have a Pithing Needle, which is, honestly, I don't even remember having him sideboarding that card, or having it in a sideboard. So that's the list he gave me. We'll see. I mean, it's Pithing Needle, so we'll board it in. It's, like, Affinity, probably, named Plating. We'll board it in against maybe Death Shadow. You can name Liliana. I'm not sure about that, though. I guess it's, like, fairly versatile in general, but I can't think of exactly what to name right now. I guess we'll figure it out. Tron and Lantern are things that I can think of right now. I guess it's pretty good against Tron, actually. You get to name Karn, or I guess Oathstone doesn't do a lot against you, but Karn does. So anyhow, we'll see how that card pans out, but it's definitely the card that I'm the most skeptical about. So I'm going to be heading in a Magic Online League, and I'll see you there. Alright, welcome to round 1. I'm going to be on the play. And we're going to mulligan this. Or I guess we're on the play. Yeah, I can't. This is tempting. Like, it would be fine. But we're on the play. On the draw, I think I would consider, but not on the play. God damn it! Where are color lands? Is that a keep? Like, we do have some early plays if we do draw land. Elspeth being in our hand is awkward, and Supreme Verdict with the Tectonic Edge is awkward. I think this is a keep on 5 on the play. I can't really go to 4. Need to find a land. Looks like we're playing against Death Shadow or Living End. Alright. No second land. Alright, he went for end of turn. Thoughts cover himself, milling Stillborn Isle, so he's probably Grixis Death Shadow. Maybe Sultai. But Blitz and Mudge makes me think Grixis. Plays Thoughtseize. It's possible that I should have conceded in response to that Thoughtseize, just so he doesn't know what we're playing. But, you know, I guess we'll try to play it out completely. Yeah, he's definitely Grixis. And we're going to be taking a ton. If I do draw a white source and he doesn't have another threat, he did scry topped up right now, though. And he has a second Death Shadow, so. And we have just that, so that's going to be game over. Now, we'll board in those Rest in Peace. Usually fairly good against Grixis. It's pretty good in general. Like, it's good against all the versions, but it's very, very good against Grixis because they have Gurmag Angler and or Tasigur, Snapcaster Mage. I don't mind boarding out, like, one Snapcaster Mage, maybe. I think Spell Snare is not that good against them. They have, like, Snapcaster Mage, and that's it. So I'll consider boarding out, like, one. Spreading Seas is great. Negate is probably okay. I'll keep Mantor. Magic Nuts. Gideon's good, Elspeth is good. Although, this is a little bit awkward against Stubborn and Isle, so maybe I would want to board out some of those. But on the other hand, I kind of want, like, I want to draw them. Obviously, if he has Stubborn and Isle, it's awkward, but those cards are, like, so good against them. It's not like I had five of those or something, I would board out a few. Just to not have clunky draws, and I have options against the Stubborn Isle, but for now, I feel like I should probably keep them. Cryptic Command is not the best card against them, it's a little slow. Obviously, don't want to be too reactive against those Stubborn Isle, so maybe this is like the card that should go. Maybe you can board out like one of those. And yeah, I guess those counter spells were not that good for kind of the same reason the Cryptic Command is not that good. Like, yeah, I just want, I mean, I guess Spellguard is a counter spell too, but it's a little bit more versatile, because it basically counters everything. I guess it doesn't counter Gurmag Angler or Tasigur, but it does counter everything else. So I think it's probably better than Negate and Mana Leak. Negate is probably not good unless they have Liliana, which I'm not sure Grixis plays. And in Mana Leak, because they play a lot of cheap spells, I think it's going to be easy for them to just play around at some point, so I like Spell Color better. I'm going to try something like that. I think that last Spell Snare could be cut easily. And maybe Gideon is not... Oops. I guess I didn't submit. I guess there is time. Okay. Well, we'll try to win without submitting. With sideboard. It's going to be interesting. And it's not like it was a bad matchup game one, so... Inquisition's probably going to take Snapcaster Mage. But I could see him taking Summer Visions, sure. It signals me... The fact that he takes Summer Visions... Well, obviously, it was my second my play on turn 2, so it's not horrible to take that in any case. But I think it could signal me, like, Surgical Extraction, for example. He would just let me play that Snapcaster, and then he would Surgical... And yeah, I did resolve that that Thought Scour because I want the Snapcaster that's in Visions, so I don't want to exile it. We'll see what his play is now. It's Dasiger. Yeah, I'm gonna counter that. I know that I have Supreme Verdict, but it's still in 2 turns. And he could still, like, play... He could still, like, Thoughtseize me or something, which I wouldn't be able to counter with that logic nut. We'll play that plans and pass. Well, so far we haven't drawn cards that we shouldn't have. So we'll play that Snapcaster Mage in response. Alright. Played a Death Shadow. I guess I'm not killing it this turn. I can probably wait a turn, right? Like, I can chump a turn. Yeah, he can't really kill me that fast, so I'm just gonna pass here. Thoughtseize, it could be an interest if he Thoughtseizes me, like I said before, but I don't think he has it, so he would have to draw it, because I'm pretty sure he would have cast it last turn. He knew that I had a Supreme Verdict in hand anyway. Alright, so he's pushing that. Interesting that he kept Bush. I mean, I guess it kills Colonnade. Elspeth. Okay, that's a nice follow-up. Feels awkward to just Supreme Verdict at that Shadow at 2-2, but it would be 5-5 super easily with just a fetch. And because Elspeth is my follow-up play, I don't mind. Although, I think I'm going to run into Stubborn and Isle here, so I might wait a turn. I could wait a turn. Yeah, there's no pressure right now. We have a Blessed Alliance. The question is, do I attack with Celestial Colonnade? I think I don't. One of the reasons is I don't want to lower his life total until I can actually kill him. But it's not super relevant right now because we have Elspeth and Blessed Alliance. I think the main reason I don't want to do that is that I think he has another push in hand. He has 3 cards in hand and he hasn't cast anything. So there's not a million things that he can have. Like, Bolt is one of them. Colligan's Command, potentially, but I think he would have played it last turn. So I'm just going to pass here. I could double tech Edgem, but it doesn't do anything right now. Like, he has mana to cast out almost anything. So I'm just going to pass and be patient. All right, Drew Thoughtscour, Mildest of 1L, and Inquisition. Cycle that street wraith that you just drew, and play a land. Spell Snare. I keep on passing. Alright, so that Spell Snare is going to be good. So my best guess right now is that his hand is Push and Stillborn Denial. Alright, could potentially have just drawn certain visions. It's possible that he was flooding too, like, I guess he did miss a line drop, actually. Bottom, top, and another one. And he did bottom top again. Then plays a Tassiger. Fair enough. Okay, so I could try to jam that Elspeth, but you just got a power or a creature with power 4 or more. So if he had that Stubborn Denial, it's gonna get countered. Maybe I should probably try to jam that Blessed Lance. I mean, he's probably going to Blessed Alliance it to Stubborn Denial it. One of the other option is that I don't play around Push and Stubborn Denial and just attack him with that Colonnade right now. It lets me keep Blessed Alliance also. If he does have Push, it doesn't let me. And it's actually pretty bad. If he doesn't have Push, yeah, it's not worth it. Like I'm in a fairly good spot, I think. I really don't have to expose myself to Push. Like I can beat Push. I basically can beat Push into Stubborn Denial. And I think if he does have the Push into Stubborn Denial and take that line, it's gonna be pretty bad for me. Sure. Four Serum Visions. Probably the card he left on top. Alright, and he bottom now. Alright, we'll play that. Escalate two modes. We'll gain life and target player sacrifice attacking creature. Target player, target opponent. Oh, Counter Squall. I guess I wasn't thinking about this one. I think he did keep two mana the whole time. So maybe that was just discard and it was never actually Stubborn Denial. We'll see. In any case, I can actually just Tectonic Edge is blue source right here. And be safe to cast that Elspeth. Yep, we'll just guess this guy. Alright, and you can see it's... Alright, well, we never drew a card that we shouldn't have drawn, so... That's good. Alright, so we'll do what I was supposed to do, which is this. This. Spell Snare, so we saw Counter Squall. I don't think they have a million of that, so I think it's still fine to just have like one. A crit tick. I wonder if Logic Knot is not just worse than those things. I mean, not worse, but I think I'm on the draw, so I guess I don't want a million Spell Killer because it costs three. It is definitely awkward with Rest in Peace. I think I'm thinking doing this. I'm on the draw though, so I can't. I think I should want to be able to cast Logic Knot in turn two. Did keep push. I don't want to have too many spell coilers. All right, I'm gonna do that. All right, I'll keep that. Same visions. Thought scare himself. And a turn to Cassiger. Which I could path right away, and I think I will. Yeah, we're just gonna path that. We're not gonna wait for him to have Stillborn Owl or Conscious Qual up. Sure, he gets a land, but they play so many cheap cards that I don't think, like, it usually doesn't do a lot. There's a chance that it actually doesn't ramp him for that turn. Now he Thoughtseize us. Let's see what he takes. He's probably going to take Mantor if it doesn't have removal, which was just the case. So I guess Mantor did its job right now. And we have a Detention Sphere for the next threat. Although I have a feeling it's going to run into Stubborn Denial. Alright. I think he might just play like Death Shadow right now. He did put Tup-Tup with Death Serum Visions. Okay, Thoughtseize me again, so no Death Shadow. Okay, guess we Spreading Seas. Spreading Seas that red source, although there's just not a lot of red cards that he's actually going to cast against me. So I kind of want to just attack. I want to get a Swamp, and so if I Tectonic Edge, I can Tectonic Edge a Watery Grave. In any case, I'm going to pull my land first, because the one in Isle. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I think it's smart. Okay. Cycle Street Wraith. It's gonna be fairly hard to deny him from having any color mana with that hand, fortunately. Okay, Snapcaster. I'll still start off with Detention Sphere since Snapcaster Mage is a lot more flexible for later. Okay. During his upkeep or at end of turn when he activates Tassigur. Okay, we want to give. I think we'll want to give him that Thoughtseize. All right, I should probably Snapcaster first. See that resolves. And then make a decision after. All right, exiled. Does he have another land like yet? No. All right, so mill two, and then we give him, I think, Thoughtseize. Oh yeah, we give him Thoughtseize. If he ever casts it, we'll just kill him next turn, so. That's pretty sweet. Right, well, now we kill him next turn, no matter what. Well, might have a removal, obviously. But I'm still gonna try it. Like him at 16, I have two colonnades. Ooh, rest in peace. Yeah, I'm still jamming that colonnade. Push something. Oh, Snapcaster. Okay. I guess I could have wanted rest in peace first, but not really, because he would just killed my own Snapcaster. And it would have been, I would have done nothing that turn. I jam. Yeah, I'd continue jamming. Thoughtseize and he dies. Alright, well, we got there. See you next round.